Hi, YouTubers and web champions everywhere. It's MargaretGeorgeTune.com. I'm back with another video. Well, in a previous video, I introduced you to some shaving brushes from the DSCosmetic company. These are really nice synthetic brushes. They're affordably priced. They go anywhere from medium to hard or rigid backbone. Very, very soft synthetic fibers. These two here have the tuxedo knot configuration, and they come in a variety of knot sizes with a variety of beautiful resin handles. Really like these a lot, very, very surprising. We're gonna be shaving with these two down the road, but the one that caught everyone's attention and caught my attention was this one right here. This is the DSCosmetic Galaxy Flat Top Shaving Brush. It has a beautiful resin handle that comes in a variety of different colors. This happens to be a red scheme, there's a blue scheme, yellow scheme, I think even purple scheme. It has a flat top knot of synthetic fibers that has a nice medium to hard backbone, and it splays out very, very easily. So if you're thinking like me that this is probably good for face lathering, I don't think you'd be too far off the mark, and we're going to find out with this morning's shave. So we're going to use this shaving brush and put it through the paces. We're going to kick the shave off with Viking's Blade Gentle Mint pre-shave oil, and I'm going to be using Tabak shaving soap. Boy, I love this shaving soap. If you're a beginning wet shaver and you're looking for a good shaving soap that builds heaps of lather, gives you good slickness and protection, and has a great old school barbershop scent, Tabak, I can't recommend it highly enough. And to kick it off right now, we're gonna get some hot water, and I'm gonna put it on top of this puck that I have here. Just a little bit like that, and I'm gonna let that soak and soften up a little bit, and I'm gonna take my brush and I'm gonna place it in the sink. I'm gonna let that soak as we talk about what else we're gonna use for our shave this morning. I'm going to be using a razor I haven't used in quite some time, the Fendrahan MK2 stainless steel razor. This is the ambassador handle configuration. They have a couple of others. Really, really nice. If you're looking for an affordable stainless razor, this is the one to get. It's about 40 bucks. When I bought it, it was about 40 bucks, and I think they still held that price. Really a very, very nice. And it has probably one of the longest center studs on any razor cap in any of my, in my entire razor collection. So it's completely stainless. Cap, base plate, and of course, the handle with the ambassador configuration is what they call. So we're gonna be using that. We're gonna finish it off with an Osma Allen block. And I'm also gonna finish it off with some Pinot aftershave. Now, Pinot Clubman, I have it in this bottle. This used to be Avon Wild Country, and the scents are similar. So I just transferred it from this bottle here into this glass bottle because it just keeps longer from what I understand. So that's why I put it in a glass bottle. And plus, I find it a little more convenient than this larger bottle here. And we're also going to top it off with some Wild Country aftershave balm. The scent, again, is right in the same ballpark as Pinot Clubman. So that's why I like to use this on my head and also my face. I had a nice hot shower, and I need the moisture. I need the moisturizing qualities of that because it is winter, it's cold out there. So, we're gonna select a blade. Got my big bowl of blades right here, and we're gonna step back, and I'm gonna shake it up, and then we're gonna just kinda close my eyes, and I'm gonna pick a blade. What's this right here? Oh, it's a Dorco. It's a Dorco ST301 platinum coated blade. These are budget blades, and give you a nice shave. I don't mind them too much. Good quality shave. And really, if you're on a budget and you want a good platinum coated blade, it'll give you a nice serviceable shave. This is a good blade to go with. Right, one thing nice about the Fendrahan razor is the end tabs are enclosed right here, which is really nice, and it has a precise alignment and balance. The blade is precisely lined and precisely balanced, so I like that a lot. So I think we've been soaking enough here in just talking about the different things that I'm going to, different things I'm going to be using for this morning shave. And the start of the show is actually the brush. So let's wet the face. Let's get some pre-shave oil on there, and let's get going with building a lather with this DSCosmetic flat top brush. Okay, I'm gonna shake this up a little bit, and I'm gonna use anywhere from 4 to 6 drops. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, something like that. There we go. I'm gonna work that into my skin. It has a nice, subtle mint scent. They call it water mint and spearmint. It's not overpowering, it's not overwhelming, but it does aid in giving you that little bit of extra slickness for your shave. All right, just gonna wipe my hands off with my hand towel here. And we're gonna go ahead and we're going to load our brush. Now, I'm gonna take this water here, this hot water, and just dump it off. And I'm gonna take my brush, and there it is right there. It's retained a lot of water, so I'm just gonna give it a gentle squeeze and then maybe a shake or two. And that may or may not be enough when we do the face lather, but I can always dip the tips of this brush back into the sink, get some more water, and continue building. But the big point right here is loading the brush, which is what we're doing right now. And I find it, it's a bit foreign, so to speak, because it doesn't have that tuxedo bulb on top. It's a different kind of brush loading. It's, you don't get that bulbous tip there that you can kind of swirl in there. It's flat. So you've got these flat bristles that are, they want to splay out, but the size of the container kind of constricts them from doing that. So I'm going to add just a little bit of water here. Just a little bit. Needed to add a little more water. And we're going to load for another, I don't know, 15, 20 seconds here. And that should be enough to have a brush load, the oil and the water setting up on my face, that sort of thing. All right, that should be enough. So there's our brush load. There's our brush load right there. And this should be more than enough to start a lather. Now again, if I'm not using enough water here, I can dip some more into, dip the tips into the sink and get some more water to help build a lather. But you want to kind of add water rather than add soap. So that's why I'm starting with a brush that's not totally dry, but hopefully just damp enough to get this going. So here we go. Wow. Okay, I need to add water, but boy, it just wants to just explode in lather right away. Look at that. And I can paint it on. That is incredible. Look how much. Boom, lather, wow. Incredible. And just adding a little bit of water helps to thin it out just a little bit to where you get a nice consistency. And I'm already lathered up. Incredible. And I think it's because this splays out. It splays out and allows you to get a lot of bristle, a lot of hair, so to speak, on your skin and just build it. I mean, look how wide that is to build up a lather. That is remarkable. So I think you have more surface area from all these hairs splaying out and then generating a lather. That's my guess. I'm going to add just a little bit more water here, just a little more. Only because I love lathering with this brush. It does a great job face lathering, it really does. I like the handle. This area of the handle right here, gives you a really nice grip, and it just lets you really have good control. Now, okay, that's it. That's nice. We're all set. We're all set to shave. That's terrific. Let me just put some hot water on my razor here. Swirl in my sink to kind of bring it to temperature a little bit. There we go. All right. 30 degrees, a light touch. Let the razor do all the work, gentlemen. All right, that's the first pass done. Let's rinse. That was a great first pass. That this shaving brush has generated so much lather. I had such a nice, thick, protective coating. I had a really nice first pass. Very, very nice. Now, I'm not double loading. I'm just setting this in the shaving bowl here, and I've got plenty here to start a second pass. My face is wet. The additional water should allow me to get another really great lather here generated with this brush. And again, watch the splaying action. It covers almost all of your face. And I can paint it on. And look, I have lather. In seconds. This flat top brush is amazing for face lathering. And of course, I love synthetic brushes to do face lathering from hard soaps. Love them. So whenever I'm using a hard soap like Tabac or Parasso or Plie de Provence, Mitchell's Wool Fat, Arco, Cella, any of those soaps, I'll use a synthetic brush because I think synthetic brushes just do a better job generating lather. And this particular brush by DSCosmetic, it does an incredible job of giving you more surface area when you press it against your face. It opens right up and look how much it's splaying out. Can you see that? It's just incredible how it displays out. So you're getting a lot of coverage there from one brush. It just opens right up and it's almost as if it's my entire cheek is covered with this brush. So a couple of swirls and everything's covered. It's amazing. Absolutely amazing. All right. Gonna add a little water here just to thin it just a little bit because there we go. Just because I'm talking and I don't want the lather to dry out too much. Okay, so we're gonna go with a pass number two. We're gonna go east to west across the grain. Okay, that's the second pass done. Let's rinse. Boy, I really love that Tabac. It just gives me so much protection and so much slickness. The Viking's Blade Gentle Mint certainly does help. For all practical purposes, I'm done, but I'm gonna do a third pass because I want to show you how much lather this generates just from a single load that we did here. And again, watch how much lather gets generated from just a couple of swirls on the face because this brush splays out so much, you get so much coverage on your cheek. So here we go. Covered. Lather. Boom. With other brushes, I'm building a lather with this one, a couple of swirls, and then I'm painting it on. Unbelievable. And it paints on so nicely. And it is a very, very soft brush. Okay, that's all we need. So here we go with our third pass. We're gonna go south to north against the grain, very lightly. All right, that's the third pass done. We're done. Let's rinse one more time here. Ha, ah, wow. Tabak offers a lot of slickness. It took me quite a bit there to get the slickness off my face. I think the Vikings Blade Gentle Mint also contributed to that. But if you are a beginning wet shaver and you're looking for a good soap to start with, Tabak. This is great stuff. And what's also nice is you can buy it, they give you this ceramic bowl, and then you can buy replacement pucks to put in there. So if you're on a budget and you're trying to watch your expenses, all you have to do is buy that, have the soap, and then you have a bowl, a shaving bowl, so to speak, that works really, really well for you. So you get them both in kind of one shot. All right, so we're gonna do our two final rinses here. One warm, one cold. Here's my warm water rinse. Okay, again, had to do some additional rinsing there. You get the tabak off. Just really slick stuff. Now we're gonna go to my cold water rinse. And yeah, that's good and cold. All right, here we go, cold water rinse. Oh, that's brilliant. That's absolutely brilliant. All right, I got a clean, fresh towel waiting for me right here. Wonderful. What a nice shave. What a nice shave. Wow, that was nice. Very, very nice. Really, the Fendrahan MK2 is a really nice mild razor, but it's very, very efficient. It gives a nice, efficient shave. And I gotta tell you, the Dorco ST301, these are platinum coated. Boy, surprisingly nice blade. I really like these a lot. They're great. They're very, very affordable blades. So if you're looking for an affordable blade that gives a nice, serviceable shave, you'll get a nice, nice shave out there. You'll get a nice shave from those. There are other blades out there that are somewhat smoother. They cost a little more. But boy, I like these a lot. I've got a lot of them, and I find them to be absolutely wonderful with a variety of razors. All right, so let's finish it off. Get some feedback here with my Allen block, my Osma Allen block, and see what kind of feedback we got here. Nice and smooth. No stinging, maybe a couple of minor zings here and there. I mean, they don't really register. Not much. We're gonna go ahead and dry that off and set it in my dish here and let it air dry so it's ready for the next shave tomorrow morning. And we're gonna let it set up. I'm gonna do a little cleanup here and we'll be back to wrap up the shave and tell you all about this brush and how it performed in today's shave. Okay, so hang in there, I'll be right back. Okay, So, look at that. Cleans up so well, almost completely dry, or it is completely dry. All I do is give it a gentle squeeze and a, you know, several snappy shakes like this and a little buffing on the towel, and look, it's nearly completely dry. And the great thing about these synthetic brushes is they retain a lot of water when you want to retain a lot of water, and they shed a lot of water when you want them to shed a lot of water. That's what's so great about these. And of course, you saw that they generate a lot of lather. Okay, let's talk about this. But first, let me just finish up my shave with a little bit of Pinot Clubman here. Oh, that's beautiful. Nice, very, very nice. Boy, I just, you get the feedback from it, and it just invigorates your skin. It's not stinging at all, it's not burning, because if you have the stinging and the burning, you know that your shave, we had a lot of irritation from your shave. I got no irritation at all, which is really, really nice. Gonna use a little bit of the Wild Country here, and I'm gonna use that upstairs, downstairs, and we'll call this shave done. A little bit upstairs here. Boy, that was a great shave. Great shave, and it can be a really quick shave because of how this brush performs. It has that great splaying quality. Look how much that splays out there. Look at that. It just, I mean, it's covering about almost the entire, my entire palm of my hand here, and you saw how much it splays out on my face. And with that, you get this immediate lather generation. It just generates a heap of lather, covers a larger amount of your face to where all of a sudden you've got lather. And what's really nice is the fact that once I get it generated with a couple of swirls, I can then paint it on. Not only does this is great for face lathering, but you also can paint it on very, very easily. It's very, very soft. I like the amount of backbone it has. It's about, like I say, it's a probably a medium to hard backbone, but it splays out very, very easily. Now, when I start doing a face lather, I start on the point of my chin, so it helps open up the brush a little more. And this one opens up and splays out very, very easily for that, for doing a face lather. It really is nice. I'm really curious to see how this is gonna perform with a cream. I like to do lathering with creams with natural hair brushes like a badger brush or a boar brush. Because this painted on so nicely, I'm going to try this with a cream here this week and see how that works as well. For some reason, it's just me. I feel that synthetic brushes work better with hard soaps and natural hair brushes work better with creams. I have been experimenting with synthetic brushes with creams, and I'm finding that they do a wonderful job as well. They really do. So, not to discourage you from using natural hair shaving brushes because they're wonderful, but boy, these synthetics have come a long, long way. Now, the other thing that's really nice about this brush is I've got my Viking's Blade razor and brush stand here, and because of this configuration of the handle, this notch in the handle, so to speak, it hangs nicely right there on my stand. Whereas with most brushes that are 26, 28 millimeters, you have to hang them up here in order to get them to dry. But this one, because of that handle, it hangs very nicely there. Now, if you have the Perfecto razor stand, that's a no-go there. So, just so you know. And it's probably a no-go there. Yeah, just barely on the edge there. But just so you know, if you have the Perfecto, that's not going to fit as well as with the Viking's Blade Admiral stainless steel razor and brush stand. Boy, I like this. It's solid stainless steel. This is terrific. Gonna last a lifetime. So that's it right there. It fits wonderfully there. You can dry it out. And again, it's very nearly dry. So, I mean, hanging it upside down, we'll get a little bit of that remnant left that's left in there. But boy, it hits these synthetic brushes. They clean up so easily. They're so easy to maintain. They're terrific, they're wonderful. And this has proven to be a really nice, nice brush. So I'll have a link below where you can get your very own through AliExpress. If they're available if they're available someplace else online, I'll also include those links as well. But a really nice shaving brush for doing face latherings. Boy, you do a face lathering in record time. I'm so impressed by that. Okay, so that's it. The DSCosmetic Galaxy 26 millimeter flat top synthetic shaving brush. Did a really, really nice job. All right, so please share. Please subscribe, hit that bell so it'll give you a yell the next time I upload a video. Comment below, let me know, do you have a flat top brush? How does it perform compared to this one? Please let me know, I'm really interested in hearing your comments. Please check out my blog, georgetune.com/blog for my comic strip George, other cartoons, other videos like this, and I'll see you again real soon.